instance, you may assume it's only adults working at this quarry, but dozens of teenagers are also part of this team. 18-year-old Elsie Anogo is one of them. He has been forced to replace his pen with a mallet as he waits for classes to resume.
With schools closed, we don't have information about when they are going to reopen. That's why I follow my mother on the quarry to help her. Working in the quarry is very hard. If you work here, you hurt all over at night. But I'm helping my mother to support our family.
With schools closed, Aminata Zaundi, like Elsie's mother, has no option but to bring along her 10-year-old daughter to work.
When she's here with me, I have to find her food, make sure she doesn't injure herself with rocks. When she's at the nursery, it's almost like she's at home.
This nursery at the quarry is the safest place for children aged 3 to 6 years, but convincing their mothers to leave them here proved difficult at first.
At the beginning, it was not easy. Women did not want to be separated from their children. It's a bit difficult to tell women to just drop off their children and then go to work. Women did not accept that, so it was difficult. But after a few years, it's the women who now ask us when we will open, even during the holidays. They don't want us to take days off because it's easier for them to work without their children.
And until the COVID-19 restrictions are relaxed and students can return to school, Elsie Anogo will continue breaking granite by his mother's side. Dominic Brian Omondi, TRT World.